Okay, dear all Espresso TV watchers, now we have the new Mazza Major Grinder, the Major V. It's a really cool machine with a flat burr, 83 millimeters. And it's a really big advantage, it's a big development in innovation. You see here the display, and what I especially like is here to remove this part, and this anti-static stuff can be also removed and changed according to the coffee. Here is up, so in this way you know how to adjust it here according to your needs, according to the beans. You have different possibilities. Somewhere is a sound. Whatever it is. Here we have different possibilities. This one is the factory setting. This one and this one. And this here is only possible with the standard one. It is for light roast. And this one here, anti-dust, I think it is more for robusta, this one here. So when you have a lot of static stuff. So here then you have the standard one and just change to this one, okay? So this is quite an interesting mode. And there is a lot of paperwork to read. It is, really important to read a little bit, you see here. All is described, so I think in 10 minutes you can understand it. It's not so super freaky difficult. And so I just put it inside again. Even I can do it. Okay, back again. And so here we go to the grind settings. With this one, it's the return. Then the dosing time, the grinding pause, and the working mode. You defined working mode. You do either here by the display, by hand, or by the filter holder here down below. Here, by pressing this one. And of course, here we have to select the working mode. So now it's the keyboard or by Porter filter. With keyboard, I just show. What does it mean? I think it's quite simple. Yes, I confirm. So then I have to take this button to go back here. So for example, here is the manual mode. That's by the keyboard or here. Now with a pause, I put to 64%. And then when I press again, for example, for the distribution of the coffee powder in the filter holder, you can use the pause. So now what I want to show is the grind settings of the working mode. You go to Porter filter. Yes, I confirm. So now I go back again and I press here down below. So my finger is now the Porter filter, okay? So as you see, same procedure. Now I have still 25 seconds to adjust the powder in the filter holder. And when it's okay, I press again with the button to insert the rest. So that's for precision distribution of the coffee powder in the filter holder. And now I want to show a little bit about the burrs. Okay, first of all, I again here setting information service. In the settings, you can also choose language, date, clock, display, and you can also connect to Wi-Fi. This is, I think, quite interesting for the smartphone if you want to connect with the smartphone. Okay, here you see this one, but it doesn't matter now. So, okay, that's the one. So now I want to present a little bit of the inside of the grinder. Therefore, I have to remove the hopper. And here we go. Here I can adjust, for example, my espresso grind set here by just, for example, putting it to 0 or to 1 or to 2 or however. So I can define my favorite point by here adjusting it. So that's really super, super simple. I can do it in the way I want. So, and here the setting of the grinding degree is the same as before. There nothing has changed. Here we go towards fine and here towards coarse. Okay, so it's the same principle. It's a left thread. But the difference is that I can remove the upper burrs quite easily. So I only need to get out the screws, that's all. So it's not that difficult, but of course you need to be a little bit skillful. Ah, this one is always resisting. Yep. So by this it's quite impressive to have a image of the interior design. Here it's really, I think a super cool engineered. And for example, the motor is pressed with the body by 2, 3, or 4 bar. I don't remember exactly, but therefore you have a zero tolerance in the vertical way. So this is super precise, and so you can clean with a disassembly without setting the grinding degree again. So you can just remove it again in this position and then screw again. And so that's quite easy. So it's a real practical grinder with flat burrs, 83 millimeter, and in my opinion, it's a really big and nice development of this Mazza grinder, comparing it to the previous model. Okay, so now it's really, super cool. Okay, I hope I could help a little bit, and in the next step we adjust the grinding degree, then we see whether it good espresso comes out or not. Okay, ciao. Hi dear all to you Espresso TV watchers. Now we are at the application mode of the Mazza Major V, and together with the Rocket R9, so it's quite a cool combination. Now we want to check whether this grinder also grinds in a nice way. Here, as I told you, you can adjust here the grinding degree. I more or less adjusted it according to my need. Here with the filter holder, you can also adjust it according to your need. Here in the width and the height, you can adjust it. Here are also screws down below, and here are screws, so you can just put it the way you want. And I just start with the manual mode. Okay, so I press here this hand button. And so this is more or less 16 gram. Then I do the distribution here with my hand, the manual leveling. And now I do the tamping. I can also press a second time if I want. And here it's quite horizontal. And now we will check with the machine whether extraction is good or not. I just start with not so much pressure, and now I increase the pressure. Yeah, according to the outflow, it looks quite okay. And then of course comes part two, the tasting. And so I think now the amount is okay. It's more or less 25 milliliters in 25 seconds. It looks hazelnut brown. Crema is okay, and now the smell experience, it has a little bit of flower minimum acidity. Ah, taste is really nice. This is a roast from Modena. That's the Cagliari Super Oro, so it's a nice brand. Also, for example, it is more powerful than the Danesi, and so what can I say? This grinder is really cool, and according to the setting, you can also do here the you have three dosages, 1, 2, 3, and the time, of course, is also important. So I just put the single dose on 5 seconds, then the 2.5 and the 4.5 seconds is not perfect yet. You can adjust it, so that's quite easy. Then of course it's easier when I change here to the language into English, otherwise my English speakers do not understand. What is here on shown on the display. So I go back here to the grind settings, dosing time. So for example here the second dose, confirm 2.5 seconds here, and then I just run up to maybe 6 seconds. So too much. Yeah. Confirm. And then return. So here we change now to 6 seconds, okay? So for example, when I insert the filter holder here, then it should grind for the time of 6 seconds. Let's see whether I'm wrong or right. Yes, so more or less these are 6 seconds, so the 6 seconds is more or less the 16 gram. As we see, it's quite okay. And leveling I didn't do 100% perfect. And so here we can do another one, just see how it the outflow is with more power. From the beginning, so you can do your own variation as you like. Yeah, this is already a little bit over extracted, so I think it's too much coffee powder here inside. According to my taste, I prefer more to for the double dose, like 15 or 15 and a half gram. But so we see it was already 30 seconds, so that's too long. And this is too extreme, I think. Yeah, I just test a small over-extraction. Yeah, too much acidity, so that's not so funny. Okay, but I hope I could show a little bit of the way how to set up the grinder and the functions. I hope it helped to get a little bit impression, and of course most important is always factor 40. Factor 40, what does it mean? Yeah, 40 centimeters in front of the machine. Okay, that's always most important. Okay, so now I switch off and say goodbye. Ciao.